Hi everyone, it's Sam from Sitemate. In this video, we're going to explore the features related to forms in more detail, such as cloning forms, exporting forms, and form branding. I'm just going to run through some simple examples to point out where all of these features sit. So right now, I'm inside a team and I'm in the templates section. I've clicked on a daily site inspection template that I've got set up. I'm just going to go ahead and create a new form. So I'm just gonna quickly fill this out. Completed by me, zone one. All barriers, signs, and controls in working order, yes. Any hazards, no. I might add some photos as an example and link those all in. And I'll say NA for that one. And I'll save it, and I've got a form that has been created. So that's obviously how to create a form. If I need to edit that form, I can simply just click on that one, open it up. If I need to change any of this info, let's say it wasn't zone one I was in, I was actually in zone two, or I got the date wrong, it's actually this date instead of the other one. I can make those changes and hit save. And then, of course, those changes have been saved. If I open up the form, I can see this activity section on the right-hand side of the form now, which tells me basically who has made a change, when that change was made, and what the change is. So I can click on here and I can see, okay, this is what it was before. So this date field was the 4th of October before, and after the change, or after it was saved, it was then the 5th of October. And same again for this this category field. It was changed from zone one to zone two. So I've got that information captured. So I can always I've got an audit trail. I can always go back and see what changes were made and when. So that in the event that I need to change it back, I can do so if required. A couple of other things that you can do on every form. You'll see up the top here, we've got some options to clone the form. So if I was to click this button here. It has cloned it, and then I can go ahead and maybe change the date again, change some of these across as an example, maybe delete these photos and add some different ones, whatever is required. This is usually quite a handy tool to have for, you know, foremen and supervisors, anyone who's doing anything on a frequent basis. So site diary is a good example, because a lot of the content inside of this form is probably going to be the same every time. So it might be, you know, more applicable to just clone it and then come in and change the details as required. And I'll hit save on that, and you can see that we've got two entries that have been set up. So if I open it back up again, we've got some options across the top here. We can send it as a PDF to somebody. So we can click that button and we can type in an email address and hit send. That person will receive an email with a link. They can click on that link and open up the PDF version of this form, which you can also download. So if I click on download PDF, we'll see that that's just downloaded now, and I can click on that. And you'll see that we've got all of the fields that we filled out. This is quite a long document, so we didn't fill out a lot of the content below what I filled out. But if I'd filled it out, obviously all of that content would be here. For now, all that matters is that the fields that we filled out are displayed here, and you can see that we've got some company branding up the top here. So the place where you set up all of this company branding is at the organization level. So if I open up the sidebar and click on SM Constructions, so our organization that we have here, if I go to this settings section inside home, so home section, and then click on the settings tab, you'll see that we have an image which we can upload, and we can also change the color, which is what you saw here. So this bar here at the top and at the bottom, we can change the color of that, and we can change the logo that you see here, and I'll show you how to do that. We can just go choose file. I pre-prepared one in advance, so we can change that there, and we can also change this color. We're going to just change it to a green sort of color, and I'll hit save. So that those changes there will occur across basically every form, every template, And also the photo section. So if I was to, for example, export a photo, so maybe I'm just scrolling through and I see a photo, or I want to export this, I can click on that photo and I can go download as PDF. You can also, you know, select multiple if required and go download as PDF, but for now I'm just going to export this one. Download as PDF. And we can open that one up, and you'll see that the color of this bar has changed and this logo has changed. So that's basically how you handle the branding changes if required. The other thing that I want to show you in this video is how, you know, within, back to the context of forms, how we display all of this information as a register and how we export the register and things like that. So you'll notice that at the top of the screen we've got timeline and we've got register. So I can actually just toggle between the two, and it's all it's doing is displaying the information which is stored inside of this form in a register format, you know, similar to something like Excel, where you can apply filters, you know, for different zones or category fields or date fields, who created it, things like that. Just helps you find your information faster. One thing I would say is that you can actually customize what you see in this register view, so these columns here. And we do that by clicking on this Edit Columns button. So I can simply click on that. These are all of the columns which are displayed. This is quite a big form, so we've got a lot of fields. But you can simply turn some fields on or off, and you can also rearrange them. So if I want to bring that photo section to the top and hit Save Changes, you'll see that now we have the photos section at the front. So that's how you edit the register view. Any changes that you make here do affect the whole team. So, you know, everyone who has access to this team and this template now views this register in this specific format. The other thing about the register view is that you can export from this view. So you can simply click to select each entry as required, or I can select all if I click this one at the top. And you'll see that as soon as I click that button, the options appear at the top here. So I'll just do that again. You'll see that we've got all of the regular stuff. And if I click this button, I've got some options. We can download the individual forms. We can export this register. So the same layout, we can export that to a PDF, or we can export it to as a CSV, which is basically an Excel file. So if you want to do some processing of all of your data, you know, and we can't facilitate that within the analytics section, one alternative might be to export it to CSV. So that's all that we have for the register view. The only other thing that I wanted to touch on in this video was workflow notifications. So if you have a template set up as a workflow, being one that where the forms which get created move from column to column based on a signature field. So if I scroll down here, we should have a signature field. Yeah, so you see we've got an approval signature field set up here, and it tells me that if I click sign, it's going to move it to the next column. What I wanted to point out was that we can actually set up notifications to occur for specific users when a form is created or when it moves from, you know, column one to column two. The way that we do that is via these little symbols that we have here. The top one, the bell, is basically the mechanism for you to subscribe yourself to receive a notification. So let's say that I'm the project director, as an example, in this particular workflow. I want to get notified when a permit moves from this column to this column, because we're looking at an excavation permit template. I would simply just click the bell, and then it just tells me that I'm going to receive a notification via email every time a form moves from this column here to this column. So I can click that bell to subscribe myself, and I can do that for every single column inside of this workflow if I want. The other option that I have is I can assign other people to receive a notification. So I could select Josh as an example, or Camilla. And basically what I've done here is I'm just making sure that these people who are selected here are going to receive a notification when something or a form in this column is signed off and moves to this column. So whenever something ends up here, these people will receive a notification. And I can remove those people also as required, and you'll see that the eyeball turns black, whereas if we've got some turned on, it will be blue. That's sort of a high level summary of the workflow notifications, and that wraps up this video. So if you have any further questions, you want to learn more about how it all works, the best place to start is always our Help Center. We've got a series of articles which cover a lot of these concepts across Dashpivot in a lot more detail. If you can't find what you're looking for, the best place to go is our live chat. You can click on this button here and send us a message. We'll do our very best to get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.